Hey guys, it's Brian, and in this video, we're gonna set up your first Facebook ad. Let's jump in. All right, we have made it to the point where we should be able to create an ad and not run into any errors or flags on Facebook's side. So I'm not gonna cover how to create a great ad in this video, but let's just create a basic ad and make sure that everything is ready to go, that we can create an ad that gets approved on Facebook, that is verified, that we're following all their new rules. So go into your business manager, click on ads manager, it'll bring you right here. Same place I just was, and let's hit create an ad. And what we're gonna do, you always wanna do, for the most part, if you're selling a product or service, you want to make your objective conversions. You can name your campaign, so I'll call this the name of the product, the Samcar product we're gonna promote, 10-step hitting system. I'll just hit continue, I'll name the other things later. So here is our structure. You have the campaign. Inside your campaign lives each ad set. Ad sets are where you decide who you're showing the ad to, your budget, your bidding, all kinds of stuff can be set at that level, and then your actual ad. So we don't have to worry about special categories because we're not in housing or social issues or any of that. We can dive in each one of these. I'll show you. These are just campaign details. It's always auction, conversions. You can do a campaign spend limit, which we usually don't. We'll just choose a daily budget. And then here's where you can do campaign budget optimization or not. So sometimes we do this, sometimes we don't. I've seen good results doing CBO on and off. Usually if I'm just testing something, I might leave it off in the beginning. Once I have a campaign or a product that is proven to convert, I might go back and turn this on. And what this does, essentially, if you have campaign budget optimization on, let's say I have an ad set that targets moms, and then one that targets dads, then one that targets baseball players. In this situation, I'm selling a baseball ebook, a training product. So what campaign budget optimization does, if I say I have $100 a day, Facebook's gonna decide if they wanna give $33 to the moms, the dads, and the players ad set, or if they wanna give it all to the dads because that's where they're seeing conversions. In the beginning, you don't really know which ad set or which target group is the best performing. So I might go ahead and turn this off. This is not really that critical. I've seen this work both ways. So I would just, you know, go with whatever you think works for you here. In the early days, I might turn this off. So if I do next, now we're editing the ad set. So let's say I'm just gonna call this one Baseball Moms because that's who I'm gonna target. If you're just setting up a campaign for the first time, just call this test for right now. Let's just double check that everything's working. So here you leave this to website. Conversion event, this is where we wanna make sure that we are seeing our purchase event here and it doesn't have this little flag. The little flag is just letting you know that according to the new protocols of all the iOS changes, that these, if we pick one of these actual actions, you can read right here why you might not want to do that. That you usually want to make sure you're only picking an action that does not have that little flag. That means that this action is set up, it's verified on that domain. You can see on the left-hand side, 10-step hitting system is the domain where if that action happens on that domain, Facebook is gonna track it for us, and that's what we want. So purchases is good to go. I'm not gonna do dynamic creative or offer. Daily budget, I might just leave it at 25 bucks. You can set an end date, I usually don't. We just wanna let this run at 5, 10, 25 bucks a day if you're just testing something. And then down here is where we can get into audiences and location and ages and all those. We can do that in another video, but I just wanted to show you guys, you can go in right now. And if I just do, let me just make an ad real quick, just to show you that it is going to work. So in this case, I know that we want to go 30 and up. We want to target women because this is baseball moms, detailed targeting. See if I can find the baseball mom keyword. There it is. I want to turn detailed targeting expansion off because I want to stay just in the people who are interested in baseball moms. Let's see. Location, you can leave it just to US. Sometimes I might expand that out. Automatic placements, leave that on. Cost control, leave that off. attribution setting. In this one, we usually just do one day click, or actually probably just one day click, not any views. This just means, hey, Facebook, I want you only to focus on people who click on the ad that same day. Track them. If we don't want Facebook getting lost in, you know, day 2, 3, 4, 5, what happens, you know, a week from somebody clicking on your ad, because they're really not that good at it. And all the changes coming down from iOS right now are going to make it almost impossible for Facebook to track those things. So we go ahead and click next. I'll just say test ad. We will go, we won't do Instagram here. We got our train baseball page because we connected it, which is good to go. Then we're going to do, let's just do add media. We'll add an image. I will go search under, let's see, stock photos here. Let this load. I'll type the word baseball. I'll grab an image here that is going to get attention. That's a pretty flashy image. And then our URL, this is where we're going to grab the URL of our actual sales page, which I built in SamCart here. So if we go back in our SamCart account, click on products, this is the product that I went and customized using our drag and drop builder here. And so I'm just going to hit preview to get the URL up here. Here's the URL. I'm going to copy it, go back, paste it right into Facebook. And boom, no errors, no nothing. It's because we verified that domain. We set up our events. Everything is good to go. So we could say, you know, how, I'll write a little ad copy here. How would you like your son to become the best hitter on the field by next summer? Check out this new program that can help make that dream become a reality. And I just realized I was typing this into the description, so I'm gonna copy that, put it up in primary text, leave a description blank. Headline, help your son become the best hitter on the field. And there we go, there's a quick little ad. Destination's website, website URL is good. Call to action, learn more is fine. Tracking, you got our URL set up to go. We are good to go here. So I could literally hit publish right now. I'll show you what that looks like now that that is published. And so what's gonna happen, because we're optimizing for purchases, number one, because we're optimized for purchases, Facebook's gonna do a much better job sending us people that are likely to buy. Facebook knows a lot about all of us, knows which one of us are buyers, which one of us, you know, don't like to spend money online, because all the other businesses using Facebook ads are tracking everything that we do, whether we like it or not. So here you go. So this ad is in review. If I'm using just the regular performance filter up here, I'm gonna be able to go in here tomorrow and say, okay, here's my reach, here's how many people saw the ad, here's the quality ranking, here's how many results, and the results that it's looking for are purchases. So I'm gonna be able to see, you know, how many purchases I got, how much it cost me to get each purchase, how much I spent, and then you can break this down and look at all kinds of cool stats. So this thing is rocking and rolling, we're good to go. We got a brand new account up and running, using Business Manager, set up our pixel, verified our domain, set up our events, everything's good to go. A lot of upfront work, as if you're watching this video, you know, because you went through all those other videos, but in the end, it's pretty simple. Once you set it up once, you know how to set it up 100 times, and it's just getting that base work, kind of the foundation created, so that you can create an ad that can track how many purchases you got, and Facebook can optimize for those purchases. So that's it. Congratulations on getting your first ad done, your account set up. In the next couple videos, we'll talk about our process for creating really good ads. This ad that I created here is not bad, but could definitely be improved. I'll show you guys how to create a really high converting ad that gets people's attention, gets them to click, and then turns them into customers by sending the right people to your product page, whether it's a long form page like this that sells a digital product, or a short form page that sells a physical product, whatever it is you're selling, how to create ads that do the job. So thanks so much for watching this far, and we'll see you in the next video.